is that?
So great.
What is it?
Larry King wearing our hat.
Larry King wearing our hat.
Tell me the story behind that.
The spiel?
Band BWP, girl rap band, were interviewed on Phil Donahue. One of the girls was wearing our hat with the bill flipped up, and on the bill it says, Huda is Alice. And I guess you couldn't really catch it, but when they paused the tape, you could see it. And a few cities decided not to air the show. And there was a big stink about it, and they put out a press release about how rotten it was, that they were getting such a bad time for wearing the hat. And they went on the Larry King show to explain it, and they stuck a hat on his head, and he wore it for the whole show.
And they kept the bill down, obviously.
Yeah.
So that no profanities were shown.
But we appreciate it. Thanks, Larry.
Larry, love you, babe. Love your body, Larry.
Love your body, Larry.
Are you into BWP?
Yeah.
They're pretty cool, man. They're treating us right. We're wearing our hat everywhere. Phil Donahue, Larry King.
So why do you have a BWP instead of an NWA hat?
Well, I like NWA better.
Larry King said when he thinks of Alice, he thinks of Alice in Wonderland.
I'll bet he does.
And then some.
Does that have anything to do with the name? No.
The name originates from five drunk guys forming a thrash band in which they would all dress in drag. And that band never got formed. And I was one of those people. And I kept the name.
Wasn't Wally there with the singer for Sanctuary? He was on it. Wally from Sanctuary was one of the guys.
Well, that was
it. I wasn't there.
Different thing, no. It's actually me and a couple other guys.
Oh.
What separates you from other kind of power rock bands?
His
and
breath.
Other bands out of Seattle, you know, that you might be compared to. What differentiates you?
I think from Seattle, a lot of the bands, they've tried to like pin the grunge thing on us, and that's not us, you know, because we're a little cleaner, a little more accessible, and you know, the grunge rock from Seattle is heavy distortion, you know, walls of Marshalls, granola in the throat vocals, and that's not where we're at. You know, we want to make something heavy that's also accessible if people will, you know, will buy into it. We just basically came up with a sound we were really comfortable with, and you know, that we enjoyed playing. And that's what we do.
Is that sound gonna change on this next album?
I don't. The basic sound we have now will be on the next album, but we're really experimenting with different styles and different ideas. It'll be different, but it'll, you know, have the same touch of Alice as the last album.
It'll have a touch of lanolin, which is good.
Just a touch.
Touch of lanolin.
With so, beta carotene.
Yeah.
All right.
Beta carotene, I'm big on beta carotene. Good stuff.
I think we're done. We can get on.
All right. Let me make sure I get this turned over.
Are you insured? License and registration.
I'm rolling, man.
God damn it.
It's all right.
Here we are on a little scenic cruise here in
Atlanta, Georgia. Driving nowhere.
Where are we going?
This way.
Look at this.
We got it covered, guys.
Yeah. This way.
Yeah, I think we just have to stop here. I'll walk down there with you.
Working.
Bus door.
The color of the bus?
Nah,
no?
Not me. There's our driver, John, right here.
Hey,
get John on here. Good guy.
All right, hold on just a second. When I'm switched.
Okay.
So why don't you be on the inside and he and I will come in this time. Can we do that?
Okay.
That's how we get the shadow going in.
I get it.
I'll just do it like that, and you can tell me when you are. You rolling? Okay, you can open it.
All right.
Can you give me the
here
tour?
We go.
Hi, nice to meet you, driver.
Here's a
busily working.
Here's our imported tour manager, Kevin, right here. Say hi,
hi
to the camera,
oh,
Kevin.
I do.
What are you doing there?
Doors.
Too long?
No, we're in on it so far. Don't forget soundcheck. 15 minutes.
All right. Perfect.
Try not to keep you late.
All right.
I want to take some bong hits. I got some pot.
It's kind of like a kitchen area right here. And this painting right here. This is a painting, fine painting by a guy named Titian. T-I-T-A-N. Honest
exactly.
To God. And as you can see, that's a fine painting of gulls on a beach.
Definite original there.
Oh yeah.
Exactly.
It's worth some cash.
Serious
cash. That's mine. So
after the dime. You wear that on tour? Are you
yes.
A big baseball hat fan?
No, I'm an NWA fan.
Now, how about this? What are these?
These are our itineraries. Tells us what we're doing every day and what time we got to do it by.
Do you lose track of where you are?
Yeah, I never know where I'm at. I just go wherever the bus takes me.
What's your last
me.
Name? Mark Ganeem.
What's the schedule like? Is it pretty
Ganeem?
Rapid?
What do you do at CBS? What's your title?
Yeah, usually. Rapid.
You get a lot of rest. The tour schedule has your dates with Van Halen, but
Ganeem.
What about the dates by yourself?
That has our dates. Yeah. All right. Now here's the bathroom right here. This
what
is
are you?
A fine bathroom. So usually the toilets are real low on these tour buses, and this one you kind of step up to it. So,
no bathing facilities?
Not bad. No, no bathing
facilities. Is that a problem?
You can't go number two in these toilets either.
No way.
Swear to God.
You
wait.
Pinch
you
it off.
Get to a truck stop. Now here's our fine bunks right here. Take a look inside one of these.
Outfit all ready to go?
Yeah.
Is that yours?
No, that's not mine. I press everyone's clothes on the road just because I get bored. So I starch and press everyone's
How
clothes.
How come there are, I guess, 12 bunks and there are only four of you?
We have crew people. Some crew people, you know, that we got.
Oh, so they sleep on the bus as well?
Some of them, yes. Some of them drive a truck.
Whose bunk is this?
This is Mike's, and I'll introduce you to Mike right now.
Okay.
Here's Mike. Look at him.
What? What are you talking about?
Look, watching cartoons.
Watching productive
cartoons here.
Reception on the bus there.
Thank you. It's not bad, huh?
And Mark.
This
Ganeem
is Mark
Ganeem
right here, but he's a mute.
He's a mute. He doesn't speak, but he eats like a horse and
whistles
like
a bird. Don't worry
so.
About him. He's
a present record company guy.
Director
out on the bus.
Of
always got
video
a record
promotions.
Weasel.
Right
always,
there. He's a total record snarf.
This is very hard for Mark keeping his mouth
shut. Hey.
Can I say that this man over here is a total record weasel, record snarf? No, I'm just kidding.
He's a favorite guy on our floor.
I love this guy. He's a good man. He's great in the sack.
You're a good man, but what are you good
shake.
For?
Thank you.
Oh my. What's the problem with the reception here?
I don't know. See, there's a problem with this bus. No CD players. They got these little hookups so we can hook up our portable CD players.
Yeah, but you gotta stand there and hold it the whole time.
Yeah, so we just stand here and rock out and hold it.
Turns every song and
holds it.
It's like, my arm's getting tired, but I want to hear the rest of this song. Mike, will you take over? And then Mike comes and takes over. And kind of. So.
When the bus moves, though, those things are pretty sensitive.
Yeah.
They jump and skip.
Actually, the portable ones are all right. They don't skip too much. As you can see, this bus doesn't have a lot of closet space. See, we got two of these. Last bus, we had a bunch of closets, so
this bus
we're not too
really
happy
compare.
About that. Well,
bus
it's
is nicer,
bigger,
it's
way bigger. So
bigger and nicer, but
roomier.
No closet space.
Is it just bigger to fit more people in, and not as
just
much
the bunks
of your own
are
personal
taller,
stuff?
Wider. You know.
Do you ever have any problem with people wetting the bed and it dripping through?
Well,
yeah,
Mike, you sleep above me.
I put plastic down.
Yeah, he started using plastic sheets and Depends undergarments.
I gotta check my shorts.
Where's those? So, and melanoma head. They'll call me that. Melanoma head's coming.
What's a skateboard for?
My skateboard. Yeah, you can video that. It's a band right here from Pittsburgh, all girl band. Very good band. Barbed Wire Dolls. Let's see what else. Oh, we went skydiving, San Diego. Dave Mustaine. So I collect the things that I do. I get a sticker from like this Silver Lake right here. We rented four-wheeled dune buggies and went like on these sand dunes that were like 500 feet up and then straight down, just sand dunes right on Lake Michigan.
Had you ever skydived before?
No, never.
So
never,
you
never
let
again.
Dave Mustaine of all people teach you how to skydive?
Yeah.
That sounds pretty risky.
He was really cool.
Yeah.
He paid for it. So that was great. And,
What's about the Guns N' Roses pass? When
was
that from?
I had to knob my way back, but sure enough. No, I went. I had a really good time at that show. It was a great show, so I had to. It was
were there
in LA,
a lot of people
so
back there?
Stick that on there. A lot of people backstage. Yeah.
Where was it?
In at the Forum in LA.
What
we were down
in
there.
LA?
We had just played with Megadeth in the Palladium. We were going to Cabo. So we were doing our video or something like that.
What were you going to Cabo for?
Play Cabo Wabo. That bar the band Halen owns.
Do you like saying that?
Nice place.
Yeah,
Cabo Wabo,
nice
Cabo Wabo.
Actually, well, what did you do there? What's the situation at Cabo Wabo for people who don't know?
Oh, it's just a nice little resort beach town, Cabo San Lucas, and the bar that Van Halen owns is like just one of the happening bars in that town for tourists, and it's a nice place, brand new.
So anybody can
fun.
Walk up and play. I hear there's equipment there that's just set out for you.
Yeah.
You can,
mm-hmm.
You
equipment set up there. No, I didn't have to. I brought
is
my own bass.
Is this stuff damaged in like a rent-a-car or something at this point?
It is after we got up on their equipment. It's toasted now.
Yeah.
Demolished.
Do you get like a free bar tab if you're friends with the band and stuff?
I get a free bowl of soup with his hair.
Them.
With his haircut, I got a free bowl of soup right over there. Check that out.
It's chili, good. Wasn't it?
His haircut, I got a free bowl of soup. Serious.
I'll pick on him.
<That's>, why,
man.
Not? Why not? Hey, let's pick on Mark today.
Well, why don't you show me, like, don't you have any suitcases or clothes or...
Let me show you
at
guys.
The hotel.
You do.
Yeah.
Where do you put them? Underneath, I guess?
Put
we
them
haven't yet. Yeah.
Underneath the
we
bus.
Gotta figure out a way to fit everything in. You wanna... Why don't we all climb in my bunk? I'll show you guys.
All right, why don't you show me out just what can fit
come on
in
man.
That small size.
Come on in.
Okay. Rolling now?
Yep.
Well, gap time. I guess they better get some Z's, you know. So.
Show us your bunk.
It's my bunk right here.
Of course, the messiest one in the row.
Can't prove that. I've never been in this bunk before.
Watch the chain thing.
But it's my nap time, so.
Good thing you're not that tall. Can you fit in this with him?
We could try. We'll give it a shot. Layne or Mark, we're both. Come on in.
Want me to climb in there with you, Mike?
He's a little lonely.
I'm a little lonely, Mike, so why don't you scoot over? I'm going to climb
in
here with you.
See, you can fit two people in these bunks.
Yeah, we just like to hang out in here.
Trying to.
Yeah.
See, Leslie, you can fit two people in here.
See, we just like to hang out in here. And like just talk about, you know, blow the whatever.
I feel like I'm in a coffin right now. But
I feel like I'm gonna start coughing, hacking hairballs all over you.
Uh oh, he's gonna
chest.
Hack up a hairball, you guys.
Do your girlfriends worry about the fact that two people can fit in these bunks?
Two men, yes.
Yeah. They worry about
worry
that.
About that. Yeah.
So there aren't wild women walking up and down the halls. You don't, like, leave the venue with a
bunch of babes
on the bus?
Not me.
Doctor's orders. Trying to cut down. What time is it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So is that kind of possible?
Take this. Call me in the morning.
Yeah. No, it's kind of like, you know, groupies are kind of, I don't know.
What's
they're
the
out.
90s rock and roll lifestyle like?
It's not as exciting, I don't think.
Not as exciting as it would have been in the 70s.
As I've read about.
Yeah.
So, exactly. We don't do things with fish and things like that.
Trying to cut down.
Sometimes we use, you know, sardines, but that's as close to fish as we've got.
Yeah.
Doesn't sound like that would be much fun.
Yeah.
So, how loud does the stereo get?
Oh, loud.
This is our brand new bus, see? We had another bus that wasn't as nice, but, and that stereo was very loud, so.
Maybe, I gotta get out of here. I'm feeling kinda
zesty.
Horny. So.
Mike, why don't you show us the,
books. I read this book called The Outside. Mike took over this one, so I'm gonna take over this one.
So what? Every tour bus I've been on looks just like this. What's
yeah?
Did you hear that?
What's that?
When we leave, your manager wants you on this stage.
Okay.
So, you can follow us or not. It doesn't really
okay, take
doesn't
throwing.
Matter. But just
all okay, right, we'll follow.
We are in the fine bus living quarters.
So what were you saying? It's hard to sleep unless you're hearing a 65 mile an hour hum in your ear?
Yeah, I can't sleep unless I'm on a bus going down the highway at 65 with a thing in, you know.
Do you get to choose what goes in that goodie box?
Yeah.
Oh, lots of Tootsie Rolls. Who won M&M's?
Lots of goobers. We like goobers.
Yeah, they call me Little Goober.
Well, most people think that the tour bus is where you want to be, that backstage is kind of pat now, and that the tour bus, if you want to meet the band and have a good time, that's where you want to be. Is that the
both
case?
Places are very boring.
Boring places. Not bad, though, you know. I mean,
once you get done playing,
have
it's
a beer,
boring.
So what do you do on the bus most of the time?
Listen
here?
To CDs. Crank
the
CDs.
Pelican, slam the lizard,
wax the dolphin.
The dolphin. Whatever it takes.
Do you have a special stereo that goes up to 11, so to speak?
Ours goes to 12.
Yeah, it's one more.
Two more.
Well, one more than 11.
Yeah, one more than 11.
All right, why don't we get you guys to soundcheck?
All right,
all right. We get a soundcheck? Wow, how weird.
Wowie, wow. I gotta get Doro Pesch's autograph before I leave today.
He's here?
Yeah.
Klaus, okay. Doro, and Dio are all here. They're all 4 foot tall. Klaus, Doro, and Dio.
Can you hold on just a second and let us white balance? Can we white balance and follow them over to the stage?
So let's do it,
right?
Klaus,
can
Doro,
we
and Dio.
Okay. All right, let's walk.
Free ball of soup with that hat.
You rolling now?
Two other guys to get.
Here, video my mood ring. There you go, huh?
That's awfully retro.
Merry Christmas from
retro.
Klaus, Dio,
yeah,
and Doro.
I've been wearing for years.
Really?
Yeah, now I've
do they actually work
tall.
After a while? They tend not to. I guess they do.
Yeah, they're going out.
You're in different moods on different fingers.
I'm in a
I'm
gray
confused.
Mood.
Stewardess, could you help
almost
me,
black.
I'm not sure what mood I'm in.
Hey, it's the frump.
So
what are you doing?
Does soundcheck really help, or can the technicians do it?
Soundcheck
and take
helps
care of
on
it?
Helps getting us
up.
Warmed up.
Yeah, we gotta warm up.
Did you get you in a certain frame of mind?
Yeah, real cool.
Just get you feel like pumped up. Or
yeah, a little
just
bit.
Like, well, I'm secure now.
A little
know
more
this
pumped
mic
up.
Works.
I feel real zesty.
Klaus DiMaggiore.
Interesting.
Bumbling around. Three
I
stooges
like that
here.
Shaky camera look. Yeah.
to give me.
I'm going to do a lot of that.
From the diaphragm. Set. Check it out. That is a piece of work right there. Piece of art. It's kind of weird, doesn't it?
Till I go back and forth.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah.
This is a brand new bass.
Brand new bass. Kramer Spectre bass. The nicest bass known to man. I love them.
Are they expensive?
Yeah, they're about $2,500. You can talk them down to like $1,800 for it. Randy, how much did you pay for this bass right here? $1,750 for this.
Why would you play a brand new instrument on the opening night of your tour?
Because I can. I love it.
Does it sound different than this one?
No, they're exactly the same, but the tuning's different on a couple songs, so I'll play this, and then this one will be tuned down to a different thing, so switch real quick with Randy, and there you have it, the same sounding bass.
Are they the only two basses you bring?
No, we got a whole bunch of them. I got an Ibanez and a homemade bass. I had a black one of these, right? It's in the shop right now, so.
One, two.
Listen to this annoying sound right here.
Do you, how many would you say you have on the road with you all together?
I have three Spectre basses, I have a black one, and I have three pieces of garbage.
I'm not sure if this is coming out because of the sound.
we die young, this E string is tuned down to D flat. So it's a real low, low sounding string, you know. The song is real low. I don't know what I'm saying here.
But that's the only difference. You can't, we wouldn't, a normal person without like pitch or something wouldn't be able to tell.
No, I can't tell. Nah.
You only use this bass on one song?
I use that for one or two songs, yeah. This is my main bass, but I just got this one, so I'm going to favor this one for a couple weeks.
Eddie Van Halen was talking about how the neck on his, he got it, I guess, not sure if he got it re-strung or something, but they cleaned the neck on it. It was really pissed.
They re-fretted his guitar. Yeah. Yeah, I don't have to have that done because it's brand new, but I will it every 6 months. 6 months or so.
Do you try to work up the same thing where you try to get it? There's a certain room to the back of the neck. Even, I mean, this is the feel. Is this the room?
Down.
You guys gonna have a beer with me later?
Going to meet and greet also.
Yeah.
Can't get away from the camera.
Started with a quick ID, you know, we're Allison Chains, we're opening up for Van Halen tonight. It's our first gig, and pass it around, like, thoughts on Van Halen, on being on part of the tour, you know. know, that sort of thing.
We just talk about. I'm pretty groovy. I rarely wear underwear. Favorite color is taupe.
Thank you.
He is groovy.
Thank you.
Okay, Ramsa.
Let's go.
We're Alice in Chains.
Really? I thought we were iced tea or ice. Vanilla Ice. We're Vanilla Ice. And we're so. Opening up for Van Halen.
We're Alice in Chains. We're here on tour. We didn't have a headlining act, so we called Sammy, asked him if he was busy, and he said, no, the guys aren't busy, and so they're coming out with us headlining on our tour.
Yeah.
We're going to let him headline this time because, you know.
We had to pay a lot of money, and I got kind of bruises on my knees and stuff, you know.
Figure it out.
They call me Stink Finger now. I don't know why.
I call him Pork Fist.
Pork Fist.
It's a little name for
that. That was last year. I'm in a totally different thing now.
So. Chicks dig me. My girlfriend calls me little. She calls me little goober. Give it to me, little goober, she says, and that puts me right over the top. No, I don't have a girlfriend. Do I? I kid.
The one thing that we're
not when you're on MTV.
No, I don't. I don't.
We're really happy because Van Halen has given us two hampers backstage. You know, one for our, you know, dirty socks, and another for poopoo undies and stuff. You know,
yeah.
It's definitely a major concern with us is being away from that type of situation, and we kind of make the mess. We got a place to put it.
We were messy babies. We were all messy babies, and that's kind of
MB.
What?
MB. That's a baby.
That's a baby. Okay,
thoughts
then.
On Van Halen?
Thoughts on Van Halen. Eddie, a couple more years, he'll pick up that guitar and he'll come into his own. He's coming around.
Yeah, I mean, he could maybe in another 10 years, the guy could be like a total legend. I mean,
and Sammy, brush and floss, brush and floss. Nah, I don't gotta tell him that.
No.
This is totally cool.
I'm blown away.
Me too.
I'm beside myself.
Can't really
look.
Say anything about it other than
over
it's
there.
Pretty happening. Very cool.
It's real muggy here, real hot and sweaty. I got a chafed fig.
Hey, I couldn't be having more fun if I was twins. Oh!
How long is this?
Richie Sambora for?
First month.
One of Lane's legs is longer than the other, so
he kind of walks.
Yet.
He walks with a limp.
Like this.
We're gonna see how it goes.
We're doing the first month, and then they take 3 weeks off, and then we'll probably just keep on going.
Yeah. Unless they get sick of us, which very.
It could happen.
Very likely.
Yeah, very
it could happen.
Likely.
They could boot happen. Us. We're not strong swimmers. I'm not a strong swimmer. And that could really hamper my performance.
I already got into something with Alex backstage. Did I tell you that? He caught me stealing his smokes out of his room. He kind of chastised me a little bit, gave me a little spanking. I'm okay. I don't think I'm going to steal from him anymore. At least not today.
I stole Sammy's water wings because I'm not a strong swimmer. And
is this thing on?
You got enough of it.
Masters of metal, we are.
We are masters of metal. We've studied. We've studied under the heavy gurus. Basically, in India, we've done a lot of internship there. We've got our spiritual heavy metalness all together, and
we're metal. We're a massive molten heap and hurkin' helpin' of metal, yeah. And that's what. That's what keeps me going
it's
every
basically
day.
Basically just hot, sweaty bodies in a steaming, humping mass.
Crew!
Sets it right up.
What do you think's going to win, guys?
Not us.
Definitely us.
Probably the Redskins.
Wait, not us? Definitely us.
The Redskins? Do you think the Redskins?
Other bands
yeah, well,
chance.
I think Da Ditka will probably get it.
He'll
you
probably
know, you
get
got,
the Bears.
You got an MTV Video Awards and a 2-inch Ditka. Who would win?
Da Ditka.
Doubles. Da Ditka. Okay.
I don't know. I hope we win. I don't think we will. We're up against bands, real bands.
Aerosmith.
No,
a lot of new bands comes with
Aerosmith, Patti Smith. Who else?
There's some total dough spent on a lot of the videos.
Is Jeff Rhodes all
too,
up
so
for this one?
I doubt it.
Because he'll win.
Jeff Rhodes is really good. He's really good. He sings.
I met
great.
Jeff Rhodes once. Rowe? He was hanging out with Pink Floyd. They were drinking a few beers.
With Led Zeppelin.
Yeah.
Were they throwing back shots and beers with their steelworking friends in
yeah,
Jersey?
Yeah, Jersey. Yeah.
Cool.
Definitely.
What'd you guys come out?
Let's check.
Well, when you guys finally were nominated, what was your reaction?
I laughed, I cried, I crapped myself.
He did. He really did. I actually, my chafe fig got a lot better, miraculously, right after that. It was quite a phenomenon.
God, you guys are fucking annoying.
Alright.
Sammy, come on, huh? Hey, it's good to talk to you, but...
And Halen.
Yeah,
definitely.
My second concert ever, Van Halen.
It's one of my top fave.
Amazing.
Top fave albums is Van Halen 1. I listened to that about for 1 year constantly. Nothing else. I'm very, very stoked. Very
when I was
stoked.
In seventh
Me
grade,
also.
In art, my art class, we had to paint our stools. Stool samples. And, it's painted stools that we sat on, and I painted the Van Halen logo, because I rock.
I etched the Van Halen logo into my first car window.
No way.
Datsun B210. Etched it with, like, that glass etching stuff. All right. Van Halen logo, so.
Did you get, like, mass chicks?
Oh, are you kidding me?
Actually,
green Datsun with
first
a Van Halen logo?
I was going to school, like, Pennsylvania, right? And, like, I didn't...
You're
going to
make up some...
No,
corny
it's
story
totally
now
true.
Too, because I
like everybody had Van Halen like on their books and like a bunch of other bands and stuff. I'd never heard of any of these bands, so I joined the Columbia Records and Tapes Club for one penny and got 13 albums, and I just ordered those because I thought they were cool because everybody had them
just
on their
ordered
books.
Ordered Van Halen 13 times, just one album, 13 covers.
I ordered the first one and the second one, and I got it totally on accident. And that's how I found out about Van Halen.
Yeah.
Yeah, boy!
Touch that, you'll go blind. Don't touch that, you'll go blind.
Hey, is Flavor around here, man? Can you just jump in here?
Flavor that, you guys.
Say, oh, yeah, boy!
Is that 13 in the house? Thanks.
All right, man.
Thanks.
All right. Thanks for the phone, man.
Hey, man.
Van Halen, this is the first concert in their whole tour. Great place to start Atlanta. I mean, you just see it starting and Alice in Chains and warming up. It's great. Okay.
Atlanta, Georgia. How you doing? Thanks for being so fucking cool to us. This is our first night on the Van Halen tour. We're very excited about it. This next song was the first single off our album, Facelift. The song's entitled, We Die Young. We'll be right back.
right, come on, right here, right here.
That's
what
you
look
like
on stage. You look like Blake. You met Blake last night.
A Blade Runner?
Oh, yeah.
You're awesome. I'm impressed, dude. Really, I am. I like the 90s, though, for some reason. I like it.
Ink bed.
Mine's Japanese, man, if I put a lot
of it. Yeah, I think I got a Japanese black one. I got a white one and a blue one. And an American.
Are you playing Ampeg heads?
Ampeg 2S and 2S.
The new ones, the FLM?
Oh. Well, the ones that are old, the 2, 3, 4, 5. They're cool.
Love now.
I love it. Nice, man. You know, he told me about that. It's Eddie Jackson from Queensrÿche told me.
He's got a good time.
He goes, use this and this. And I did, but I cut out all the effects and he told me it just went straight.
I play God.
Hey, man. You can borrow it. It's not really as sharp as that. Yeah, I can't play it.
Gaffer's thing.
Huh?